If you are creating an online course, then you're probably interested in automating your online business. Today, we're gonna tell you what, Hector?
The three pillars
of e-learning so that you can automate each pillar and not have that three-legged stool fall down.
We are e-learning partners, and this whole entire channel is for us to partner with you to simplify your e-learning so you can
focus on the
most important thing, which are your learners. So we also have a free masterclass. Johnny, tell them about it.
All about your learners. We go through the three pillars and how your learners impact the pillars, and it's free, instant access guaranteed. Below the video.
Go right below the description. So let's jump into how to automate your online course.
Pillar, what is it, Hector?
It is content.
Content. So the content pillar, this is the hardest pillar to automate. But once you do, or maybe you don't even need to automate it, because once you create that course, as long as you don't want to create more courses, that's it. That's the great thing about e-learning and online businesses and online courses, is once you create the product once, you can sell it over and over and over and over. So there are three parts to content if you do want to automate the process itself. The first part is pre-production. What does this mean? Pre-production is all about how you script your content, how you figure out what content you're actually developing. How do you figure out what kind of content to develop, Hector?
You need to ask your learners, identify what are the biggest challenges that your learners have, and based on what your learners' needs are, their personas, the type of content that they want to ingest, that is the type of content you're going to be creating.
This guy's starting to sound like me. Better though, because he's Greek. So number two is production. That is the second part of the process. Production. Now, the easiest way to do production is to use tools like Loom. Check out the link below. Check out the link up here for a video all about how to use screen capture videos and Loom to create training videos and online course videos. But production is all about actually producing the content. So the simpler you keep that, the easier it is to automate. But remember, once you've actually produced the videos or your online course, you don't need to do it again unless you make updates or if you want to sell more courses in the future, which is why really in all this, what you're going to learn is it's better to create one course and sell the out of it, and then creating more and more and more courses. Make one course that sells really good and automate that before you move on to other courses.
And the third piece to this is post-production. Now, what post-production is after producing all the content, you gotta edit it. You gotta edit it based on your learner's
need. You
gotta put it together. You gotta listen to your learners. You gotta make sure that you're making content that your learners want. Now, here is the thing about automation. Yes, content, pre-production, production, post-production, but how the heck do we automate this part? It's very, very simple. Make sure that you are documenting. Document everything that you are doing within pre-production, within production, within post-production. And the more content you produce and the more experience you have within these three categories for your content, the more that you're going to figure out what you can outsource to start automating this whole entire process.
Exactly. And the easiest one of these three to outsource is going to be post-production. Now, the pre-production and the production, you're probably going to have to be involved in some degree, but you're not going to have to spend as much time doing it the second, third, fourth, fifth course that you create after you've automated the heck out of that first one and sold the crap out of it. But now let's talk about technology. Technology is the second pillar of e-learning. And the great thing about technology is there are specific technologies out there, LMSs out there, that allow you to automate the crap out of your course. So what you're gonna do is check out one of two technologies that we really like to use and that are, in our opinion, the best technologies to automate your course. The first one is Kajabi. Link below this video for our Kajabi affiliate link. By hitting that link, what you're gonna do is show your support to us, and you're gonna get a 30-day free trial instead of just a 14-day free trial.
I would appreciate the support, of course, team.
Exactly, and if you wanna learn more about Kajabi, we have a whole playlist linked above about how to use Kajabi to build and launch your online course and sell it. The second one that you want to check out is Learn Worlds from the motherland,
of the Grace Learn Worlds team. This is another incredible platform, very similar to Kajabi.
Also
the key difference between Learn Worlds
There's
and Kajabi is that Learn Worlds accepts SCORM files as well. Now, like Johnny said, we have whole playlists about this, but very, very quickly, Kajabi, Learn Worlds, very user-friendly for your learners, very user-friendly for you.
And also, it allows you to automate the crap out of your course.
Exactly. And one last thing that we love about Kajabi and Learn Worlds is that not only is it a learning management system, but it also brings so many things.
The sales and marketing.
Email
that
list.
We're about to go into
everything.
In distribution, you can do in Kajabi, and most of it you can do in Learn Worlds. So number three is distribution. So distribution is broken into four areas. When you work on these four areas, you are going to be able to automate the sale of your course, the distribution of your course, the marketing of your course. So the first thing you need to figure out when you're talking about distribution are your marketing channels. What is a marketing channel? Is it you turn on the Discovery Channel, you're checking it out, you go to the National Geographic Channel, you're checking it out? No, it is like using this, YouTube, or using TikTok, or using
LinkedIn,
Facebook, or
Twitter.
LinkedIn, or Twitter, or I'm just saying shit that he's saying now. But basically your marketing channels are what, Hector?
They are areas where your learners can find you, so they not only can interact with the amazing, remarkable, free content that you're giving to them, but most importantly, you're giving them the ability to access your free lead magnet, which is the
number
second thing here.
Lead magnet's so important. Now, what type of lead magnet should you create? We ain't got time for that today, so you're gonna take a direction up ahead over a top. So somewhere up here, and we have a whole video about what kind of lead magnets you should build for your course. But lead magnet, the key here is value, value, value. Don't just give something away that is what, trash?
That is half butt.
Half butt.
Remember guys, in order for you to make sure that you're providing values for your learners, you gotta build a relationship with them, right?
Yeah.
There is a lot of people out there.
Are you building?
A lot of competition out there, lots of courses, but there's only one you with your system and your process and your method. And believe it or not, some of the content that you have, give it away for free because they are gonna interact with it through that free lead magnet. They're gonna interact with it. And after going through all that remarkable content, the chances of them purchasing, whether if it is right then and there or later on as they interact more with your brand, is a lot higher because you are giving them amazing, remarkable content that is changing their life as we speak.
Exactly. All you really need is one really good lead magnet. You want to see an example of a really good lead magnet?
Free Masterclass. That's a great lead magnet.
Number three, email sequence, an automated email sequence. Now, this is cool too. Once you build out the email sequence once, all you really have to do is read the data that Kajabi and Learn Worlds has for you, and then you can make tweaks to that email sequence.
Email sequences are so powerful because essentially what an email sequence is, are your sales individuals, mm-hmm. because that is what's gonna be doing the selling for you. When people interact with your lead magnet, they are giving you their email to access that lead magnet, and then those emails are connected to the email sequence that is created that will act as your salesperson to get them to ultimately purchase your course.
If you wanna see an email sequence, you know what to do.
Click on that free masterclass.
Number four are landing pages. So this is the last part of distribution that you need to automate your course business. Landing pages are what people are gonna hit when they're going through your email sequence, when they're getting your lead magnet. It's just a really easy way to put up a page online that people can access, that you direct traffic to. So when you go and check out our free masterclass, you're gonna hit a landing page that asks for your email. That's the lead capture form. Then when you fill out your email, you're gonna have another page open up, which is the actual lead magnet, which is our free masterclass. And then you're automatically gonna be put into an email sequence, and the rest is history.
And within that masterclass, you'll be able to learn more about our course, which is another landing page, really
exactly.
Showcasing an even deeper dive of the course and the value that you will receive. As you see, everything is automated, which makes things so powerful.
If you're interested in digging deeper into our favorite marketing channel, we have another video all about how to create an online course that sells. So go check it out.